Normally when I produce, I do like this. I start to do everything that what is in my head. So brothers, jitterbuggers, hipcats in fancy hats and pretty girls with pretty smiles, all decked out in the latest styles, rough taking, hip shaking, cute as now. It's easy. I'm getting still funky. No, we have to go out of that.
You're not just gonna sit in front of your computer and go, I know, that's a good idea for a bass line. You know, it's like fishing for pearls or trying to get anything. You're going to go through tons and tons of shit before you get the gem. I'd rather scroll through sounds for hours than sit there for hours trying to mold something into what I want it to be. The key for me is, it sounds like the same for you, is removing stuff.
Yeah,
and finding the thing that is the most valuable inside there.
Exactly.
Because the other bits can make that less valuable.
I think that people can learn that sometimes it's not necessary to be, you know, I see many tutorials that I put the EQ like this, I put these effects like this. We will focus more in the production, in the sounds that we use.
Hopefully people will get the collaborative side out of it, and also being able to delete stuff, because there's as much value in that as adding. In fact, as I've been going through this industry in 25 years, it's been a skill I think I've got better at.
All the ideas are simple, but it's because we
delete.
Everything
has its place, yeah, everything has exactly its value. If it's not bringing something to the party,
exactly,
then it goes. It's not just there because it looks pretty on the arrange page. It's got the most amount of processing in the whole track.
For what? Maybe because it's from the plugin, you know?
That fingerstyle bass has got the most amount of technique going on in the whole track. So, what have we got there? Bass amp, crikey. Too much to fit in. Trying to fit it in.